I'd like to introduce Lynold Tuiloma, who is a Nanakuli High School junior this year.
That's
set to graduate next year, and with plans and expectations to be graduating with a scholarship to go to a mainland college and show them what it's all about, right?
Right, but before that scholarship, I want to get that diploma first, you know?
Of course you will. And also, Lynold is one of my students. Lynold has an IEP, and so I work with Lynold. He's on my base list of SPED students. And what I would like to let everybody know is that Lynold has a specific learning disability in the area of reading comprehension. So with that in mind, and I'd like to let everyone else also know that you've done an amazing job of facing this challenge and overcoming it, and you have very good grades. And you maintain an active sports schedule too. So Lynold, why don't you tell me about yourself, just about who you are. What kind of person are you?
First of all, my name is Lynold Tuiloma. I'm named after my father, Tuiloma. And my reading comprehension, oh man, I could take you guys way, way back, but let's make it long story short. So I've had trouble with reading, and the way I overcome it was I like to read books about football because I love football.
Mm-hmm.
Ferguson, I love football, and
good.
It makes me feel at home when I'm reading something that I can compare to, you know? And that's all about I read. I read magazine football. It's all about football for me, man. Anything to do with sports, you know, it's I'm there.
Okay. So that's your choice of reading, but when it comes to your academic side, you do well in class, so I think that your abilities have risen in the content areas as well.
Yeah. In class, oh man, there has been a lot of obstacles in my past towards my grades and stuff. And I've learned how to overcome it because one thing about my family, we go by this traditionally, Nam-myoho-renge-kyo, it's to pray for ourselves and to pray for the others that are around us, to give them great faith and to lead them in a path that we want them to be. You know, we don't want nobody to have bad intentions to anything. We as an individual will expect that person to be self-centered and self-calm. And for me, it's all about if I can do the work, and I'm showing somebody else that I can do it, I'm being self-centered.
Okay. No, I mean, you show a great example. You don't get a big head. But and I tell you this a lot, I recognize your leadership qualities, and you apply that to yourself. You've shown great self-determination, and thank you, Lynold, for doing great work at school. And
yeah, no problem.
You know, best to you always, okay? How you doing, Lynold? Good to see you again after you got an opportunity to take all the pictures you wanted to for our video project here. And I took a look at what you shot. They're very interesting. Why don't you tell me about about each one.
All right.
What do they mean to you? How does it personify who you are? Where you've been and where you're going? That kind of covers. Okay.
Okay. So the first picture that came to my mind was my dad's MVP picture, which was on the wall in the gym. And then as a small child, I always used to look up to my dad, and he started the whole football thing in our family. That's when I knew I was destined to play football and everything. So this is a picture of my father.
Right here, this one right here.
Yeah, this is
what's your dad's name?
My dad's name is Lynold Tuiloma. And he was an offensive tackle and a defensive tackle for Nanakuli High and Intermediate School. In the year of 1986, he was a West All-Star.
1986?
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah. And then the next picture I took was this hawk
right
on top of the basketball court, but it could mean many things to me, and it does mean a lot of things to me. Well, it represents my color, and wherever I go, my father would always tell me, represent your colors proud, and I specifically, everybody would tell me, represent your colors proud, because
mm-hmm.
I am proud of where I come from.
You should be.
And
you should be.
Yeah. And this is a picture of the hawk. And this is who I am. Nanakuli is not what I do, it's who I am, it's what I'm about, you know?
Good. I like that. I like how you say that.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
And then, in this school, I like to keep active, like playing sports. I play multiple sports. I couldn't take a shot of my track and my paddling, but just know that I'm a part of that area too. So one of them, like basketball
okay.
is a really big factor for me, because my sister, I wish I could take a picture of my sister then too, but I couldn't because they're unfortunate enough, because they're always working and stuff, they have a lot of things on their mind and
mm-hmm.
a lot of things on their plate. So basketball is one of the sports that I really love.
Was she a basketball player in Nanakuli?
Yes, she was.
Terrific.
At 2004, she was a basketball player.
Okay.
And she didn't make the wall, but she played hard, so I know. And by playing basketball and football and stuff, I always gotta keep in shape and good and a good look. So I like lifting weights a lot, and I like running. These weights, this weight room is special to me, because in Nanakuli we're special to have this, and in a couple other schools that I know of, they don't have this type of weights that they can go to every day. You know.
Right.
You know, and we are very blessed to have this type of weight room. It was just built recently, a couple of years ago, and I'm very fortunate to go there every day and have no problems like those people over there, like they saw me yesterday, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's really good. And then getting into my personal, I like football. The football field is me, man.
Number one, right?
Number one, yeah. That's what I want to be in the future, a football player. That's what I want to do, and that's...
What position do you play?
I play defensive tackle and defensive end, and I play a second string offensive lineman as backup if
okay.
they need me. And so the football field, I'm not going to lie, the football has saved my whole family, not just me individually, my whole family. And by seeing football do these wonderful things for my family...
How did it save your family?
Well... Started off with my brother. My parents then was going through a little phase when we were young, and
mm-hmm.
then my sister then would always tell us, football is gonna be your guys' way out, and you'll never forget, football is gonna save your life. And as a young age, we didn't know what that meant, but my brother Lyle, he could understand already, because
right.
he was a little bit older than me, and I was just a little kid in my own little world, you know? Like, do-do-do.
Yeah.
But, you know, football, football taught us a lot of things. Football taught me character. Football taught me how to carry myself around places, the time and place. Football
mm-hmm.
taught me how to be disciplined. Football taught me how to be accountable for myself and to be accountable for others if needed. And football has taught me toughness.
Yeah.
You gotta be tough. It's either tough love or just plain tough. Football is a really big factor in my family, and it's absolutely a really big obstacle in my family.
Yeah. You know, I didn't get to know your brother Lyle very well, but I met him mm-hmm. at the end of his senior year.
Right.
And I just, I did get to know him. That was the important
yeah,
part.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
And then, of course, you and I.
You mean you go way back.
Which is good. I feel fortunate to have had you in my classes. But let's continue.
All right. And so the biggest thing that runs in my family, we are Buddhist practitioners.
Okay.
We practice this religion. I'm not really too deep in it, but my sister makes me practice it every day. And I didn't understand why. Why do we have to practice this religion?
Mm-hmm.
Why, you know? She said, it's a part of us. It's who we are. It's what you are. And then I'm like, why? I'm asking all these questions. She's giving me no answers. First thing she tells me is that you're going to figure out why on your own. Because it's you. This is you.
Yeah.
And then we say this chant, Nam-myoho Renge-kyo. It's praising to ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
We believe in ourselves, and we're giving faith to everybody else. I mean, we don't want the worst for anybody. We hope the best for everybody. We give no negative vibes. We everywhere we go, everywhere we carry ourselves, it's Nam-myoho Renge-kyo, Nam-myoho Renge-kyo. We're praising our loved ones that passed, and we're thanking them for everything that they done for us and what they left behind, their legacy. And we're thanking them about what they left on the table for us and
mm-hmm.
what they left for us, you know? It's that kind of thing, that small little things that this religion does for us.
That's not a small little thing, that's a big thing.
Yeah.
That's good.
And I didn't realize it was a big thing until I lost my ability to walk, Mr. Ferguson.
When was that?
I broke my foot
okay.
at a football camp.
Okay.
I broke my foot at a football camp, and then I'm gonna chicken skin because I was thinking of this when I was going into surgery. Everything makes so much sense because when you're in a life deficit, I'm like, oh, I'm not, I can't walk, I can't do anything. Life is just ruined for me. And then I'm thinking in my head, everything makes sense now. Everything is falling into place for me because like I lost my ability to walk. I gotta keep a strong mind. I gotta pray every night now. I just gotta hope for the best for me. And I'm hoping other people is hoping for the best for me too. You know, because that's all I hope for other people. You know, and I'll keep a straight line ahead of me, and then I'll just keep moving. That's who I am. And I kept praying every night, and for sure I felt the prayers. I felt it getting stronger in me every night. You know, every time we had a football game, standing on the sidelines, observing the other football players, making judgment calls, like I would tell a friend, oh, don't do that, do this, because I'm there, you know. And Mr. Ferguson, it was the worst football year ever in my life because I was in crutches.
Yeah.
But then again,
standing on the sidelines, you got a different perspective.
Yeah.
And you got to give a lot to the team
mm-hmm.
by your misfortune.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Oh. Awesome. Awesome.
So this teaches me a lot about patience, good judgment.
Good. Well, I see that evident in your everyday life. I really do. What else we got here?
And, well,
you're
we got
wrestler.
Yeah,
wrestler.
I'm a wrestler. Well, this is my first year of wrestling. I went into the mats thinking that I'll just go in here and get a workout in. You know, I'm not trying to be the best, but I went in there with a low-key mind. Like, I'm here to be here. And that's the kind of mentality, I'm going to be honest, the kind of mentality I went in there. But
you still give it up your all every time
yeah,
you walk in there.
Yeah, but the funny thing is, Mr. Ferguson, after I lost my first match, this 2 weeks ago against this guy, little kid,
mm-hmm.
man, I wanted to be the best. And I trained every day hard for 2 weeks straight, and then we went to Wainai Gym, and I dominated.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
So now I'm 2-1.
Okay.
And I'm gonna keep this record until I meet that kid again, and I'm gonna make a statement.
Yeah, there you go. That was a surprise.
Yeah.
Yeah. he'll walk up going, this is the kid I beat, and it'll be a different Lynold.
Yeah, and you know, talking about all these sports and stuff and all of the praise and stuff, always comes back to school. I love school, you know. That's the one of my first things that I ever mm-hmm. wanted to do is school. And school is very, very important, you know. I say this to myself and I preach it to myself every day, a student athlete. You're a student yeah. before you're an athlete.
Yeah.
And then I tell my football boys that, or my wrestlers, or my basketball players, or my paddlers, I tell them all of that, it's a student before an athlete. No matter how long it takes you in the class, if you have no grades, you cannot play the sport that you are in.
True.
You know, and then I preach that to my friends every day. And for sure, the people that I surround myself with, they're playing their sport every day because they're a student athlete. Yeah, I love school. That's the only thing.
It's a great perspective you have.
Yeah.
I mean, that is the way it is. Not everyone shares that perspective. I'm glad you have it though.
Yeah, Mr. Ferguson.
And your grades reflect the efforts that you're putting in.
Yeah.
You know, you're doing well, and it doesn't come easy.
Yeah.
You got some tough classes that you're mm-hmm. taking, and you know, you're doing well enough. Good for you.
Thank you, Mr. Ferguson. Well, I really wish I could have took more pictures over the weekend, but I didn't, and I love sunsets. Yeah.
Okay.
Like sunsets.
Yeah, they're good. We're on the right part of the island for sunsets, aren't we?
Right, yeah, we are.
Yeah. Hey, do we have anything else? Was that your last one?
Yeah, I think that was my last one.
Okay.
Well, unless you want to see the videos, you want to see the videos?
I think we'll keep this video a little short. I've looked at them, and you videoed the wall, right?
Yeah.
Who's up there? Your sister's up there, your dad's up there. Is your brother up there?
Yes, my brother Lynold Tuiloma is up there, and the reason why
your sister's not up there, she didn't make the wall.
Yeah, she didn't.
She
make
got
the wall
in your heart, but not
yeah.
not in the school. Okay.
Yeah. So the reason why I took a video of the wall to see those past loved ones that left the school, they left mm-hmm. their legacy, and then I paused on the blank wall for one reason and one reason only, because one day I'm gonna fill that wall. I'm going to be up there.
Good.
I'm going to put in the work.
You'll be there next year for sure?
For sure,
yeah.
Man. I'm striving to be up there this year and next year.
Okay,
Mr.
I can't wait to see your picture up there.
Yeah. Yeah, Mr. Ferguson. That blank wall, I'm going to be up there.
It's reserved for you, right?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
I just can't wait.
We'll see you there, Lynold. We'll see you up on the wall. And it won't be a blank space anymore.
It won't.
Okay, Lynold, just... Thank you.